Hello and welcome back to Old Bailarol. So first things first today, we need to get our bales cleared up on here. Let's get a few gears up on this to start with. The optional creeper box for the tractors as well, or optional in real life, so it's got more gears than standard. Spent many hours on one of these back in the early 2000s. We're not a 7250, 7230 what had been opened up to match a 7250. I say match, exceed the power of a 7250, I think would be nearer the mark. Ultra reliable tractors, head gaskets aside. We could need to put money on about every 5,000 hours. Certainly an experience for the ones locally. Most of the time I've spent with either a 6 furrow mount or 7 furrow plough on one of these. So I've had a look at the straw prices. Certainly won't be selling any yet, we'll try and keep it through to the winter. Still a lot of cars here. Can use our shortcut to get back. I'm gonna see if we can tip this up in the middle of the barn. Be interesting anyway. Anywhere it'll be in the middle. So no problem tipping that there. Real test will come when we can put another stack against them as to whether the physics are improved. We know in 19 if you put another stack of barrels near the existing ones they would wobble, move, do all sorts of strange things. At least that gives us a little bit to sell. There's a few more there. Put them down, then we'll move on to our next plan. Which is to really increase our revenue source. Need to get front weight for this tractor as well. Still need a sprayer. Potentially a couple of other bits and pieces as well. So this one is the test. See if they start to do the bail dance. Not yet. Well, they're dancing. Not falling over, so that's a start. So, no movement, all behaving themselves. We can always move them back into the shed further once we get a telehandler, which we probably will do. Now, so 9,430 kilo bales there. Now we need to look at how we can make some extra money. And this bit of the field looks ripe for it. So, just move myself out of the way a bit here. We're going to look at maybe things we can do. So we'll go with some greenhouses to get going with. So put one down there. Another one there. So I have three big greenhouses there. Take a look at my ground level and just see what's done to the terrain. Nothing on this side, thankfully. Not done too much on this side either. Done a little bit there. And there. I do wish you could get down at ground level for this though. Because it is very, very hard to see what's going on up here. So we'll do a bit of painting around there as well, just to tidy up a bit. Ourselves a gravel roadway in around them. Let's face it, you wouldn't want grass around your greenhouses. You might want grass around them, but you wouldn't want to have to cut the grass around your greenhouse. Always a nerve-wracking experience, stones and glass. Just to add to that, I just gonna need a water point. Should pop down there. And just to finish this corner off, it's a bit of a waste of space now. Paint that in. Back to painting so I can see you missed a little bit of stubble there. And obviously we'll probably not crop this bit, we'll save that for other purposes. It's a bit unpredictable still in the minute sometimes. Bear in mind we're going to be using help to plow this field, so we need to just screen it slightly. Just to stop them from trying to plow up what we don't want them to. That gives us somewhere else just to maybe put something if we need to. So what I've got to do now is go and get a water tanker. So I will just buy one limb from the shop. If I remember where they are. Buy one of those. So I'll go and pick that up and I will see you in a couple of moments. Okay, got a water tanker now. Whilst I was down the shop, I also picked up a front weight for the Magnum. Bit overkill with this tractor, I do know. It's the quickest one. But I've still got a little bit more to paint out there. Might get ourselves a smaller tractor. Depends what we put in this part of the field, I have an idea for that. It won't be yet for a while. We'll take some of that money out shortly as well. Don't know how much water each one of these takes. We're about to find out. Quite a lot, so just put a little in each at the minute. And I'll fill them up properly after the video. So get this filling up again. So manage production point. Oh, they can take a lot of water. So we'll put tomatoes in this one. Lettuce in this one. And finally, strawberries in that one. And we'll see what pays the best. Just leave them running now. So that's our next step all set up, ready to go. So on that note, that's where we'll leave this video. So I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.